Hi, welcome to this session on grouping of data. In this session, we will discuss the need for grouping of data. We will discuss how we can perform grouping of data with group by clause of select statement. We will also demonstrate the use of group by clause statements in SQL. Let's start this session.
It is important to first understand the need of grouping of data. Grouping of data is used to perform aggregate function on a group instead of whole data. For example, to find total number of students in each class, we have to apply total function on a group of class, not on the whole data set. Similarly, to find out total number of boys and girls students, we have to apply total functions for each gender group, not on the whole data set. To find total number of students from each city, we have to apply again total function on each group of city records, not on the whole data set. To find maximum marks scored by boys and girls students respectively, we have to apply maximum functions for each group of gender. So in all these cases, we have to apply aggregate function on each group of data instead of all the records of the table. And to perform grouping of data, group by clause of select statement is used. It is used to make a group on a particular column or group of columns. It divides the rows in a table into smaller groups. The syntax of group by clause is select column, group function, from table, optional where clause, optional group by, and optional order by. It is important to note that in group by, we can supply group by expression to make a grouping on a particular column. We can also use where clause and order by clause with group by clause. To understand the working of group by operation, let us take an example of employee database, where we wish to find the total salary of employees for each department. Then in order to find total salary for each department, first task will be to make a group on department number column, and then some function will be applied on the salary field to find the total salary of each department. And in SQL, we have to use group by clause on department number column to make a grouping on this field. And then some function is applied on salary field to display total salary for each department. To illustrate this concept, let's find total salary paid to employees for each department for employee database. Here we have 5 columns with employee number, e-name, job, salary, and department number. And we have 9 records in this database. There are 3 records for department number 10, 3 records for department number 20, and there are 3 records for department number 30. To display total salary for each department, salary and department number column play important roles. So let us simplify this data by selecting these 2 columns. Then grouping will be performed on department number column, and 3 group will be created, one for department number 10, another for department number 20, and third group for department number 30. Then some function will be applied on each group to find total salary for each department as shown here. The query to display total salary paid to employees for each department is select some salary, comma department number, from employee, group by department number. Here we have aliased sum salary function to total salary. So in the output, total salary and department number will be displayed. And we have used group by clause to make a grouping on department number column. To further understand the role of other constructs of select statement in a group by clause, let us consider second task to display total salary paid to employees for each department number excluding job title professor. So in this case, first step will be to exclude the undesirable records before making the group. And in this case, we have to exclude those records where job is equal to professor. Then after excluding these records, group function is applied on department number to find total salary paid to that group. So in this case, department number and salary column will play a vital role. So let's select these two columns. Here again, three groups will be formed, one for department number 10, which contain two records, for department number 20, which contain three records, and third group for department number 30, which contain two records. Then sum salary function will be applied to display total salary for each group as shown here. The query to perform this operation is select sum salary, comma department number from employee, where job is not equal to professor, group by department number. Here we have used where clause to discard job title professor before making the group on department number. In this example, we have shown the usage of where clause with group by clause. Here task 3 has further been extended to arrange the output in ascending order of total salary. And to perform this, we have to use order by clause. So here order by total salary has been added in existing select statement to arrange the record in ascending order of total salary. Let us consider another task 4, where we have to find average salary paid to employees for each department number excluding professors. So then in the same way, first task will be to exclude the record of professors. Then grouping will be made on each department number. Then after making the grouping, instead of finding total salary, we have to find out average salary. So then average function will be applied on each group as shown here. The query will be select average salary, comma department number from employee, where job is not equal to professors, and group by department number. Let us perform the next task to find out total number of employees in each department. Here we have to first make a group on each department number as shown here. Then count function will be applied on each group to find out total number of employees. The query to perform this task will be select count, comma department number from employee, group by department number. In task number 6, we have to find out total number of employees in each job. In this case, there is a need to make group on the basis of job field. To illustrate its working, let's arrange the records in ascending order of job as shown here. Then grouping will be made on each job. For example, a group will be made for job assistant professor, another group will be made for job associate professor, and third group will be made for job professor. Then count function will be applied on each such group to find out the total number of records in each group. You can clearly check there are 4 employees working in assistant professor, 3 employees are associate professor, and 2 are professor. And the query to perform this task is select count, comma job from employee, group by job. So in this session, we have learned about the usage of group by clause, where clause, and order by clause of select statements. Let's execute these statements to demonstrate this concept. Here we have employee table with 9 records, column E number, name, job, salary, and department number. We have 3 records in each department number 10, 20, and 30. And we also have job titles as professors, assistant professor, and associate professor. Now let's apply some grouping operations on this database. In order to find total salary paid to employees in each department, we have to make grouping on department number. If I execute this query, it will show the total salary paid to employees in each department number 10, 20, and 30. We can arrange the output in ascending and descending order with the use of order by clause. So here by adding order by department number, I can arrange the record in ascending order of department number. We can also exclude some of the records before making the group. Here we are excluding the records of job title professors before making the grouping on department number. And if I execute this query, it will show the total salary in each department excluding job title professor. To find total number of employees working in each department, we can use count function with group by on department number. If I execute this query, it shows that there are 3 employees in department number 10, 20 and 30. We can also find total number of employees working in each job by making grouping on job title. It shows that there are 4 assistant professors, 3 associate professors and 2 professors in this database. It shows the concept of grouping of data.
Now let's summarize the concept we have learned in this session. In this session, we have learned about the need of group by statement. We have discussed the syntax of group by clause, where clause and order by clause of select statement. In next session, we will discuss the need for grouping on more than one column, and we will also discuss some common errors performed by users during the usage of group by clause. Thanks for watching this video.